For this video, we're going to take a look at solving an inequality that is a compound inequality like you see right here in a table rather than a graph. In the last video, we had this graph and we solved this same compound inequality using a graph and the internet in a section command under math F5 in our calculator. Now we're going to take our calculator and have it do a table. Now, notice because we already had this in our calculator that we already have negative 2 in the y1, we already have 2x minus 4 in the y2, and we already have 8 in our y3. You can go ahead and leave it like that for the table, or you can just compare values by looking at the y2 column in the table. Now, the first thing we need to do is set up our table in order to view a table and find the solution to this compound inequality in the table. To do that, we're going to hit the green diamond button, and then above F4, notice that it says table set. So we need that. Now, on this, it has table start. That's where we want to start. And we're not quite sure where the solutions are, so we need to start at a value that's low enough that we will probably get our solution. How about if we go ahead and start at negative 5? So we're going to do negative 5, and make sure you use the negative symbol to enter that. If you do the minus, it will give you an error. And then notice that right below that, there's this little triangle in front of TBL, which is short for table. The little triangle is a symbol we use in math for change in table. Well, this would be change, and then the table after means change in table. Now, right now, it has it changing so that in between each value in our table, we will have it go up by 1. If you need something a little more accurate, you can have it jump by halves by putting in 0.5, or tenths by putting in 0.1. It depends on how accurate your problem wants you to be. Jumping by 1 is probably going to be fine for us. Now you have to hit enter twice, and when you go to your table, which will be the green diamond button and table, you will see all the values for your y1s, y2s, and y3s. Notice y1 is always negative 2 because that's what we told it to be. y3 is always 8 because that's what we told it to be. So what we need to do is basically just arrow down in our calculator and find when this middle column, which is the y2s, and is also representing our 2x minus 4, is greater than or equal to negative 2 and less than or equal to 8. Now, to do that, notice right now the values are smaller than negative 2. So we're going to arrow down until we reach a value of 2 in that y2 column, and then we're going to compare what happens before it and what happens after. So we're going to use our arrow key, and notice it's arrowing down the x values, and we're going to watch till we get to negative 2. And oh, notice right here where the x is 1, we got to a spot where the y2 is negative 2, and it also matches our y1 column. We need to compare what happens right before it and what happens right after, because we want y2 to be larger than y1, or y2 to be larger than negative 2. If you look at just before when x is 0, the y2 is negative 4, which is smaller. If you look just after, the y2 is 0, which is larger. So it looks like we have this situation for this part of your inequality here happening from 1 forward. So we can actually start our interval notation by using a square bracket, since our inequality has a line under it, and having 1 as the first value in a comma. Now we need to continue on through our table to find out when this y2 hits the 8, because that's going to be our next spot where we need to examine. So if you arrow down farther and you watch, notice all of a sudden y2 is 8. So we're going to go one more so that we can take a look at what happens just before it and what happens just after. Notice at 6, the y2 is 8.
If we look just before it, the Y2 is 6. 6 is smaller than 8. And in this statement here, we want this 2x minus 4, which is our Y2, to be less than or equal to 8. Well, just before 6, it is less than 8. And at 6, it's equal to 8, which is what this line right underneath the inequality is wanting. If you examine just after 6 on your table, notice that the Y2 is 10, and 10 is larger than 8. So once you go past 6, we no longer have this situation here being satisfied. So 6 is your turning point, and we want everything before 6, which means in our notation here, we're going to put a 6 for the ending spot, and since we have a line under our inequality, we will use a square bracket. This is saying that the x values that satisfy this compound inequality are when x is greater than or equal to 1 and less than or equal to 6, which is what we found in this table. Our interval notation will look like this, and notice that's the same thing that we got when we solved this by graphing. Our set notation is going to require us to take this statement here, put a straight line for such that in front of it, and then an x, and then use set brackets around this statement. And we read this as the set of all x such that 1 is less than or equal to x, which is less than or equal to 6. And that is how you would solve using a table in the TI-89. Now let's take a look at our Casio.
Notice that in the Casio, because we did this same problem by graphing, we have all our values in the Y1, Y2, Y3. And we still have our graph here. Once we have that all taken care of, we want to go to this button right here that looks like it has little tables next to the Y1, Y2 button. If you press that, notice that this table shows up here. If you want to view the table larger than it currently is, you can go down here to this button that says Resize, and that makes it much easier to view a table. Now, notice that on this table, we only get 3 columns. If you use the scroll bar here, you can move back and forth across. So notice I can scroll over and see Y2 and Y3, and the X's stay the same over here. Now, I'm currently just concerned about Y1 and Y2 in order to take care of this part of the inequality. Once we are done with that part, we'll use the scroll bar to scroll over and compare Y2 with Y3. Now, we need to set this table so it's doing everything correctly. Right now, it's jumping by 5s, which is 0.5s, which is just fine. However, if we want to make it look like the one that we had in the TI, here's this button right here with the 2 arrows and the X and Y. Click on that, and it'll ask where you want the table to start. And starting at negative 2 is fine. If we want to make it match what we had in the TI, we can punch in negative 5. And it also asks where you want it to end. Well, we're not quite sure where we want it to end, but we need it to keep going for a while. So how about if we have it go up to 10? And then the step is going to be how far it is from one entry in the table to the next entry. Right now it's jumping by 0.5 to make it look like the TI. We'll just press in 1 and then click OK. Now, if you look at it, notice that these X values go up by 1 and it starts at negative 5. And if we scroll down using this scroll bar here, it goes all the way to 10. So let's take a look at the column and glance down and find where the Y1 and the Y2 match, and they match right here when X is 1. Again, if you just look just before that, you'll notice that at X equals 0, we have a Y1 of 2 and Y1 of negative 2 and a Y2 of negative 4. Negative 4 is smaller, and we want negative 4 to be larger because we need the Y2 to be larger here than Y1. So that before where X is 1 is not going to work. So look just after at 2. And if you look at the 2 here, the Y2 is 0 and the Y1 is negative 2. And 0 is larger. So after
this spot where x is 1 seems to work for our statement where we want y1 to be smaller than y2. So that, again, gives us the first part of our inequality. Now we need the second part of our solution over here. And in that, we want to compare y2 to y3. So if you just scroll over and then continue down, you'll notice right here at 6, they match. So if you compare just before that, the y2 is 6 and the y3 is 8. And 6 is smaller than 8, which is what we want in our solution here. We want the y2 to be smaller than the y3. If you look just after here, you'll notice when x is 7, y2 is 10, and y3 is 8. Well, 10 is bigger. We don't want y2 to be bigger, so the things after 6 are not part of our solution. That means that we need to finish off our inequality the same way that we did here for the TI. So that is how you use your table function in the Casio here,
and you write the solution the same way over here that you see we did for the TI.